Welcome. You want to use Python, but you're not sure where to start. So in this video, we cover things that you need to know about how to use Python and how to code. So let's start with the basics. You may be familiar with some programming techniques, but new to Python. So you may understand some of these. But if you don't understand, don't worry. This is just an introduction. So we start off with a simple print statement. So here we print hello world, the string hello world. There are other ways to print this. You can see we can use double quotes or single quotes, or even have different strings inside the brackets, or even strings added together. That's a simple print statement. And that will print hello world to your screen. Comments, just use a hash symbol in front of whatever you write, and you can use the hash symbol in front of many lines if you want to take them out. Assignment, so if you've got a variable like x, if you want to give it a number like 7, you can just say x equals 7, or a string, here we've got number equals 7, which is the string 7. These are called types. So the main types are, if you like, the text are strings, and numbers are either integers that are whole numbers like 1, 2, 10, or something like minus 1, or if there's a fraction, decimal point, like in currency for example, you can use floating point numbers called floats. So in text you use string, str, and in numbers you use integers, int, and floats. There's a way of writing the syntax when you're coding, and in Python it's slightly different from other languages. We can see some examples here. If you don't understand this code, don't worry, they'll be explained in their own videos. So here's just some examples. We have an if statement. We have an example of a loop, which is a for loop, and we have an example of a very small function. So there's some examples of the syntax in Python. One thing you'll notice is there's a slight gap at the beginning of the code sometimes, and that's called an indentation. And in Python, when you have a block of code, it doesn't use brackets, it uses this space. This is used, as you've seen, in if statements, loops, and functions. So remember that the space actually means something in Python. So if we have a look at the examples, we have an if statement. And if that statement is true, then Python will run the next line. And it knows only to run that one line because we have the gap in that one line of code. The same for the for loop. What does it do inside this loop? It does the code that has that indentation. Again, we see the same indentation used in functions. So when you define a function, what code underneath is inside it? Well, we know because we use that indentation. When using indentation, you might have many blocks of code inside each other. So you don't just have one indentation, you can have more. In this example of a function, we have a for loop, so that has starts at the first indentation point. Inside the for loop is an if statement, so that starts at the second indentation point. And inside the if statement, we have a print statement, and that starts at the third indentation point. So we can see which code is inside which other code. So how does Python know when the code stops being inside? We write the next line without any indentation. So for example, if we have a for loop, and we have a print statement, then it will continue to print that. And once the for loop finishes, we see another print statement that has no indentation. So that's not inside the for loop. So we have one print statement that has indentation, so that's inside the for loop. And we have a second print statement that has no indentation, so that's not inside the for loop. One thing about Python that's very different from other programming languages is the typing. So for example, here we've got x. X is a string, but the string, the text, is actually the character of number 1. But that's not an integer, that's not a number. So if you try to add an integer, a number, to it, then there's an error. So if you try to add 1 plus 1, if they're not both integers and one of them's a string, then that will be an error. So you have to be very, very careful of this, and a lot of mistakes are made by this. So always check to make sure your variable is the correct type. An example when this happens is when you ask a user to input a number. So in this example, a user enters a number and puts it into x. Now when they enter the number, if you add 1 to the number, you'll get an error, which seems very strange. But with Python, an input, when someone inputs a character, it doesn't matter if it's a number, an integer, or a string, or letters, it doesn't matter, it will always be a string. So even if someone enters a number 1, Python treats that as a string. So therefore, if you do some maths with that string, there will be an error. So what do? The solution is that you can change the types in Python. And here's an example where the user enters a number into x, and x is a string. So we need to change x into an integer. So we can use the code x equals int x with the x in brackets, and that will change the x from a string to an integer. Okay, the second part we look at actually using Python. So you've looked a little bit coding. When you write code, so for example the print hello world code, how do you actually run that? How do you use it? Well, you'll have Notepad on your computer. If you open this and you just type in the code print with hello world in brackets, if you save that file and make sure you call the file name, when you name the file, use the ending .py, not .txt. .txt is a text file. You want a Python file. So it's very important you finish with .py. So save that file. In this example, you can call your program My First Program. So myfirstprogram.py. You can either save it on a desktop, so you know where it is, or if you're organized, you can create a folder or choose a folder and put the file in that folder. It's important to know where the file is. To run the program, we need the command prompt. So if you're not sure where it is, you can click the start button and put CMD inside the search box just above the start button, and that will bring the command prompt up. Now you need to know where your file is. If you've put your file on a desktop, you can actually drag the file into the command prompt, and that will make the command prompt go to where your file is. And then you press enter to run that file. If you created a folder or put the file inside a folder, you need to change the directory in the command prompt where your file is. So for example, if you've created a folder called My Python Files in your documents, you would change directory using that CD for change directory, and then have where the file is stored. So you change the directory, and once you're in the same directory as the file, just type the file name. Make sure you have the .py and just press enter. The command prompt will know it's Python with the .py. And if your code is correct, you should print hello world. If it's not correct, you should get an error message. One thing you might think, well, that's great for running the program, but it's quite easy to make an error. So rather than use Notepad, there's something called Notepad++. Now, we'll cover installing that in another video, but assuming you've got Notepad++, you can open that normal way you'd open a program, or if with your file you can right click your Python file, and if you click edit, you'll probably be taken to Notepad as a program that will open and edit your file. And if you open your file, you'll see that the code is in color, so it's much easier to see any mistakes and to realize what the syntax is inside Python. But remember, when you save the file, you have to save it as a .py file, a Python file, and you need to know where you saved it. So if you're going to run Python files, you can either use a desktop, or my preference is to use a folder and then go to that folder in the command prompt and then run each file when you like. You may decide that you want to use something more advanced. You don't need to. Notepad++ is all you really need. If you want to use another more advanced editor, or you want to use more advanced things with Python, you can use something called Spider as an editor, and that comes with something called Anaconda. And what I suggest you do, if you're new to this, is to look online and research Anaconda and have a look to see what it does and if you really need it. And then Spider is quite easy to use, and if you really want to have a video on how to use that, we can do that. The main thing to look at when you're installing anything is, have you got a 32-bit or a 64-bit computer, and what's your operating system? So if you're using Windows and it's 64-bit, make sure that's the correct download, either Anaconda or Python or anything else. When you've actually installed Anaconda, to run Spider, you just type the word Spider in the command prompt and then the editor will come up. Great, we've come to the end. So can you name anything that's been missing? One thing that you would really like to know, something you'd like to ask? If you can write that in a comment, I'll see if I can reply to it. Great, don't forget to subscribe.